Assalamu alaikum, my name is Iqra Rashid and I'm from BS English 8th semester. Today I'm going to discuss about a novel, Home Fire, written by Kamila Shamsi. First of all, I would like to introduce Kamila Shamsi. Who is Kamila Shamsi? Kamila Shamsi is a British Pakistani writer. She was born on August 13, 1937. She was brought up in Karachi and her writings or she was influenced by a Kashmiri poet, Agha Shahid Ali. Her well-known novels are In the City by the Sea, Salt and Saffron, Cartography, Broken Verses. And now I would like to introduce the novel I'm going to discuss. It is the seventh novel written by Kamila Shamsi. It was first published in 2017. It was written in English language and it was published by Riverhead Books. The novel is written in the form of a play, Antigone by Sophocles. It is the reimagination of the play, Antigone. What is Antigone? Antigone was a tragic play written by Sophocles in 441 BCE. It is the story of a girl who protests against state for her brother. I'll be discussing it later with in comparison with the protagonist of Home Fire. Summary of the novel. It is the 24th century adaptation of the Antigone. Antigone was written in 441 BCE and the novel Home Fire is written in 21st century in the at the format of Antigone play. Kamila Shamsi reimagines the events of the tragedy as if they were unfolding among the British Muslims in modern London. The tragedy happened with Antigone is taken as the tragedy is going on with Muslims in London nowadays. Kamila Shamsi herself, an immigrant from Pakistan, wrote the novel only after she became a UK citizen. She wrote the novel after getting the nationality of the Britain. As if she writes the novel before getting the nationality, there would be fear that she won't get that nationality. This is the story of two Muslim families, Pashas and Loans. Pashas are the Muslims or practicing Muslims and the Loans family is the family that is Muslims by name. They are not practicing their Islam. Isma Pasha is the head of Pasha's family. Her parents had died. Her father was a jihadist and her mother died when she when her younger siblings were 12 years old. She brought up her younger siblings Anika Pasha and Parvez Pasha. They were twins. And the novel opens with Isma Pasha. She was flying to USA but she was stopped at Heathrow Airport because of her hijab. She was wearing hijab. Being a Muslim, she did not bring anything that could discriminate her. She was just wearing a hijab and she was stopped due to that hijab at the airport. The officials asked her many questions. They were asking her about their views about Shias, about homosexuals, about the Queen's democracy, and they wanted her to present her as a British. And that detention causes her to miss her flight to Boston. She missed her flight and she stayed at London Amherst, and she started to take online classes. At a cafe one morning, Isma meets a 20 years old Eamon Loan. The two became friends. Eamon Loan was the son of British Home Secretary Karamat Loan. And they became friends. After some time, Isma admits to Eamon how she feels about him. Isma falls in love with Eamon Loan and she tells him that she loves him. And Eamon Loan refuses his love, refuses her love by saying that we are just friends, nothing more than friends. So she tells him about his father, that she used to hate his father. She had feelings of aggression and hatred for her father. The reason I'll be telling later. Eamon tries to justify his father, but she did not try to understand. Then Eamon flies back to London. Upon his return to London, Eamon visits Isma's aunt's house in Wembley, where he meets Anika. He falls in love with Anika. Anika was a bit reserved girl. She did not reveal anything about her identity, her family background to Eamon Lone. But when Eamon Lone proposes to Anika, she tells him that there was her twin brother who left London and went to Syria to join ISIS. And she wanted him to come back. She wants Eamon Lone's help to bring him back. This was the reason why Isma Pasha has the feelings of hatred and aggression for the father of Eamon Lone. In the meantime, Pervez serves in the media wing of the Islamic State. He went to Syria through a man named Farooq. He joined ISIS. He was working in the media wing, but after joining ISIS, he realized his mistake, and now he wanted to come back to London, but he doesn't have any means to go back. One day he talked to Anika on Skype. After hearing her voice, he became passionate to go back, and both of them arranged to escape in Istanbul during a trip. The trip was arranged by Farooq to get new recruits to ISIS, and Pervez arranged with Anika to escape during that trip. And in Istanbul, Pervez runs to British consulate in Istanbul to tell them the truth, that he has joined ISIS and he wanted to go back to London. Farooq finds him on the steps of the consulate and he shoots him from his car. Pervez was killed by Farooq, and Karamat Lone refuses to repatriate his body, sending it to Karachi, Pakistan. He announced him as a traitor to the state. That's why he did not bring his body to London. That was the reason why Isma Pasha hates Karamat Lone. Grief-stricken, Anika flies to Pakistan. She wanted to get back the body of Pervez to London. She wanted to bury him in this in London. Karamat Lone refused it. The following day, when the body of Pervez was sent to Pakistan, on the following day, Eamon flies to Karachi to be with Anika. He was in love with Anika. He did not want to leave her alone, so he went to Pakistan to join her. As soon as he reaches the park, there was a park where he wanted to meet Anika. The two men came up to him and they strap a belt with explosives around his waist. And seeing Eamon, Anika runs up to him. Anika came to him. He was protesting, "Don't come to me, don't come to me." But she did not hear to him, and the two of them embrace. This was the summary of the novel. The end is not clear that whether they died or not. Now I would like to discuss briefly the style and settings of the novel. I'll be discussing the themes in detail, so I am discussing it briefly. Akin to plays, five acts, the book is in five sections. The play Antigone was written in five acts. That's why Kamila Shamsi wrote the novel in five sections. Each of the section is described from the perspective of a major or key character. Characters are being discussed later. The novel is told in free indirect discourse. The novel is not told directly. It is told in free indirect discourse. Free indirect discourse is a phrase which deals with the thoughts, imaginations and feelings of the characters. The events are going through the consciousness or unconsciousness of the characters. They are being told through the views or views and thoughts of the characters. The events are not explored directly. The novel is set in 5 locations: London, Amherst, Massachusetts, Istanbul, Raqqa, Syria and Karachi, Pakistan. It is set in modern day England with South Asian characters. And the style of novel Homefar is told from 5 different perspectives of the key characters. 5 characters are the key characters of the novel. There are 5 sections of the novel. Each section is being described from the perspective of a character. The author switches perspectives as a way to slowly deepen the reader's knowledge about events and provide greater understanding of the characters and their motivations. Pervez has joined ISIS. This was not told directly to the readers. It was told by both of the sisters, Isma Pasha and Anika Pasha. It was implied by both of the sisters that their brother has gone to Syria to join ISIS. It is self-described reworking of the Greek tragedy Antigone by Sophocles. And now I would like to discuss the characters of the novel. There are 5 major characters in the novel. Isma Pasha, 28 years old woman, her younger sister Anika and her younger brother Pervez. Anika and Pervez are twins and they are 19 years old. Their mother died when they were 12 years old. Isma brought them up, and when they are mature enough, so Isma has decided to continue her studies. That's why she decided to fly to America, but she was stopped at Heathrow Airport. She was not allowed to fly. And Anika's boyfriend Eamon, and Eamon Lone's father Karamat Lone, the British Home Secretary. And the dilemma which faces Homefar's protagonist Anika remains the same as that faced by Antigone. Antigone's brother was also announced a traitor to the state. He was not allowed to be buried in that state, and the Antigone was protesting against the state to bury his father, bury his brother in that state. That's why the tragedy of both the protagonists is same in the novel and the play. The themes that are being explored in the novel are fidelity. There is fidelity between characters. Isma has fidelity for her younger siblings, also for the state. She was a British, she was born in Britain, so she was British by birth. She has fidelity for his state, for her state, for her younger siblings. Loyalty, she was loyal to her motives or motivations she was doing in the novel. Identity, there was identity crisis in the novel, as they were British Muslims, but the Britishers did not consider them equal to the English Britishers. They were discriminating them, and Pervez was suffering highly from the identity crisis. He heard about his father that he was a jihadist and died in Afghanistan during torture. He was confused between the Muslim and British identity. The theme of law is explored in the novel throughout the novel, especially as regards burial rights. Pervez was British national, but he was not allowed to be buried in London due to his act of joining ISIS. Even though he just joined ISIS and the media wing of that state, he did not commit anything that is against his own state, British or London. There were many Londoners who had done violence against the state, but their identity or their nationality were not detached from there, as it was detached from Pervez. and the law laid by the gods versus law enforced by men. The law laid by the gods is that if someone is national of some state, he has to be buried in that state, and Karamat Lone refused to bury dead body of Pervez in London. This was the conflict between the law laid by God and the law enforced by men. There is sacrifice. Isma has sacrificed her many years of life for her studies for her younger siblings. And Anika was now sacrificing her career, her life for the dead body of her brother. Issues of immigration. If someone migrates from one state to another state, he has to face many issues of immigration. Isma Pasha was facing also that issues. Even though she is not direct immigrant from Pakistan to Britain, she was born in Britain. Second generation citizens. Isma Pasha was second generation citizen in UK. She was born in UK. Her parents migrated to Pakistan and she was born in Pakistan. If a family lives in a foreign country for 3 years and their child has born, the child would be considered as the second generation citizen of that state if he or she is registered within the 12 months of his or her birth. Terrorism. The theme of terrorism is explored in the novel. ISIS is an organization which is considered to be a terrorist organization by many states. So when Pervez joined ISIS, he was considered to be a terrorist and he was considered a threat to state. That's why Karamat Lone refused to repatriate his body. Familial love is natural or instinctual love between parents and offsprings. Pervez haven't seen his father throughout his life. He was only hearing about his father that he was a jihadist. He was heroes of extremist and traitor or terrorist to the state. Despite of hearing bad words about his father, he had love for his father. He had love for his sisters. His sisters had love for him. The instability of national identity for minorities. If a minority, if a person belonging to minority is doing something that is against the state, their nationality would be in threat. His nationality could be detached from him. This is the instability of nationality. Islamophobia is the fear of Islam. That is, Islamophobia is a stigma that is pasted to the Muslims of foreign countries. If there are Muslims, if there are practicing Muslims in foreign countries, they are considered to be terrorists and their Islam is considered to be a terrorist organization. The Pasha family was practicing Muslims and the Lone's family was only Muslims by their names. So the Islamophobia was attached to Pasha family rather than to Lone's. Racism. Racism is also a fault or a problem that is faced by the Muslims. If Isma Pasha was a British national, she was born in Britain, but she has to face the racism problem throughout her life. She was not considered British by the other Britishers, as they were born by Britishers and she was born by Pakistani parents. There were tensions between the state and the ethnical religious minorities. Tensions between the states, like state was facing threats. State was considering that it has threats from Muslims and Muslims were facing problems from the side of state. And the awards that were won by the novel are: the novel was long listed for Man Booker Prize in 2017. and it was shortlisted for DSC Prize for South Asian Literature in 2018, and it won the Women's Prize for Fiction in 2018. In 2019, BBC listed Home Fair on its list of the 100 most influential novels. If you have any questions, you can ask me in comments, and thank you for watching my video during the COVID-19 pandemic. Stay home, stay safe, and keep your beloved ones safe. Thank you and Allah.